The reports coming from Amnesty International and Human Rights Watch. Executive Director of the Middle East and North Africa Division at Human Rights Watch, Sarah Leah Whitson, joins me now. Sarah, great to have you with us. Now, while Saudi Arabia initially defended the killing of Khashoggi, it initially defended it, saying it was an interrogation gone wrong. Now, Human Rights Watch is just one organisation revealing what interrogators are allegedly doing inside the kingdom to dissidents. What can you tell us?
As the report we just put out this week documented, a number of the female activists who've been detained in Saudi Arabia have reported terrible abuse, including electric shock, whippings, and other assaults of a sexual nature. This, I think, is really quite unprecedented in terms of the abuses that we've documented in Saudi detention facilities in the past. And it's very hard not to de-link this from the murder of Jamal Khashoggi. It is very much a reflection of the Saudi government's attitude towards how it treats people who have independent voices in the country or outside the country.
Now, do you have direct access to these detainees? How are you getting this kind of information?
Well, we have a number of sources that have provided us with this information. But as you'll note, our report is deliberately vague because those who are in detention and their families are terrified of retaliation. Family members have themselves received warnings and threats about any sort of information coming out. It's a very, very difficult position for the detainees and their families to be in. It's a very difficult position for us to be in possession of information, knowing that even disclosing a little bit of the information that we have is very risky for the detainees themselves.
So then what is your organization calling for, and who are you calling on?
Well, obviously, first and foremost, we're calling on the Saudi government to release these detainees from their unjust detention, from persecution against them, merely because they have expressed independent voices in the country through their writings, through their activism. The women activists, of course, are not the only ones. There are religious scholars who are being detained and facing a death penalty. There are Shia protest activists who are being detained, including a woman facing the death penalty. There are writers like Rafe Badawi, who's continuing to serve a 10-year sentence merely for his writings advocating for reform in the country. So, first and foremost, the Saudi government should stop its endless persecution of activists in the country. But in terms of the international community, we have to recognize that remarks like President Trump's makes the U.S. complicit in these abuses, in a very open and transparent and naked willingness to say that even if MBS committed this terrible crime against Jamal Khashoggi. That's okay, because we have some interests that makes that okay. That's got to end, of course, as well as the arms sales and the support to the war in Yemen that makes the United States a party to the war and complicit in the war crimes that are going on in Yemen. We have a broad call that's existed for a number of years now that all states should suspend arms transfers to Saudi Arabia and the Saudi-led coalition in Yemen.